In this video, I'm going to teach you how to apply effects to your entire video without having to apply effects to each individual clip. Let me give you an example. This is one of my favorite editing jobs on YouTube. Google Within Temptation, Faster Isle of Man, or Isle of Man TT. Basically, this is a street race held at the Isle of Man. But the footage here is just phenomenal, and the editing is even better. Let me play you a bit of this and show you kind of the effects that I'm going to show you how to create. Just a nice motorcycle race, a little bit of lens flare off in the bottom corner, some flashes there, bright lights, another little flash there of a bright light, and you'll see some of these effects all throughout this entire video. A little bit of a vignetting going on here. Obviously a lower third for the name, and a bunch of other effects. Let me play this for just a second longer. You have that little bit of flickering there, a little bit of lightning going on. And I know that's easy to do in when you're applying it to one video, but if you have a hacked up timeline like what I've got here of a bunch of different tracks, it's a real pain to add that to every single clip. So let me give you an example of what I've got here. I've got just, of course, I got some music in here because I just like it so much. Let me turn my volume down. I've got just a bunch of different clips of a local track meet here. Just nothing really fancy here. Just some javelin throwing, some track going on, some sped up action, some slow down action. And what I want to do is I like to apply that that flickering effect or a lens flare effect or whatever through my entire video, but I don't want to have to save this to a video, bring it back in, add all these effects. What I want to do is just apply this to the entire clip. So here's how you do it. So put your cursor at the very beginning of your video, and then go up to under Project Assets. On the top right hand corner, there's going to be a panel options. If you click that option, there's where you can view things, change the sort order, a new folder, and a new item. This is the key thing that you want to do. You're going to want to find something called an adjustment layer. I've tried adding effects to things like titles, black video. It just doesn't seem to work very well. But if you add an adjustment layer, it doesn't add it to your clip. It adds it to your project asset. Then take your recent adjustment layer, drag it into video 2, video 3, you know, whatever, just above your tracks here. The way these things work is they render from the top down, so it's going to render your adjustment layers first, and then render things below it. So I'm going to increase this thing to the entire width of my video. Now, don't pay any attention to the adjustment layer that I have to the far right. This is a completed one that I already have done, so I can show you some of the examples of what I've done after, instead of to sit and hack this whole thing up. All right, now that you have this adjustment layer, as I dance my cursor around, it doesn't seem to have any adjustments because I don't have any adjustments. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go down to my effects, and I'm going to add maybe a, let's go to my favorites. Where are my favorites? Frequently used. And we're going to go to, how about image control? I'm going to drag image control right on top of this, and it gives me the ability to control the brightness and everything else. Now, your applied effects may not look like this. It may be in what I call sort of a collapsed state, where you don't have this keyframe thing shown and even not that wide. I'm making mine very wide so you can see things, and I'm also turning my keyframes on. This is the key thing, no pun intended, on what you're going to need to do to your adjustment layer. So that little stopwatch up there called the show hide keyframes, you want to turn that on. This allows you to adjust each of these settings at various points along your video. So what I'd like to do is I want to add that little like the light popping effect in there. So notice if I change my brightness, it changes it for the entire video. I don't want it to do that. Change it back to 0, I think it was. We're going to turn on the keyframe by this little stopwatch here, the toggle animation, and it puts this little marker here for me that's going to remember that spot being 0. Now if I go over just, I don't know, a couple seconds into my video or whatever, I'm going to add another one. I'm going to zoom in my timeline here. And I'm going to go right next to it, just a couple of keyframes over, or a couple of frames over, I'm going to add another one. So I've got 0 at the beginning, 0 here, and 0 here. So why am I adding all of these zeros? Because I'm going to put my cursor somewhere in the middle. I'm going to change it to some drastically, annoyingly bright amount. Then I'm going to go to a little bit further down the video. I'll add another zero, another zero, and somewhere in between, you guessed it, I'm going to add another, that's too close, add another little kind of a light flicker there. So when I play this thing, what it will do is it's going to play through all of these keyframes and adjust the brightness as it comes to each of those keyframes. So here we go. And I may have had it too low. Let me stop this and we'll try it again. So let's go back to our keyframe here. And let's go to the previous one. And let me zoom way in. I think what happened here is these are a little too close together. There we go. I think I just had them a little bit too close together. So you have to play around with this thing to get the right amount of setting between it. Basically, what was happening, it was my cursor's going so fast, it didn't have a chance to render it. Now, if you save this out, you would get that. But you see that little flicker there of that bright white light, which, you know, whether you like it or not, it's up to you, but here's how you do it. Now, I can add a million of these things all over my entire video to get that little flickering effect to happen when and wherever I want it to occur. So let me just crank this up even more to make it even more annoying on your eyes, just to really accentuate it so you get an idea of what this thing is going to look like. I actually think these things are way too close together. That's why it's not even rendering it live for me. So let me just space them apart a little bit. And there you go. You saw that little flicker in there. So now you can do this all over the video if you want to. I'm just going to do it one time to give you an idea of how that works. Next thing I like to use is the infamous lens flare. So we're going to drag it on top of our adjustment layer. And by default, it's going to add this lens flare to my entire video. And I know that's extremely annoying there. So what we're going to do is maybe at the very beginning, I want this lens flare to kind of pan across the screen. So you probably guessed it by now, you do it with these little keyframe things here. So what I'd like to do is at the very beginning, let me turn my brightness all the way off. I'm going to remember that brightness, and I'm going to remember the center of the lens flare. So at the very beginning of the video, I want it to be at the left-hand side. I want it to zip across to the right-hand side and sort of pop somewhere in between. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to make sure I go across a couple of frames here. So this may be very slow, very annoying, but at least you're going to get the idea on how it dances across different frames. Because the whole point of this thing was how you add effects to multiple clips without having to render out your video and all that kind of good stuff. So let's go ahead and remember this zero flare right here at this point before the clip. And after the transition, I'm going to remember it again. And then somewhere in the middle, I want it to be very, very bright. So let's go ahead and crank the brightness way up just to show you what it looks like. I don't think it's particularly cool, but nonetheless, that's how you would change the effect. Now, what I like to do is have the lens flare to be off to the right. So this is kind of a hidden secret here. If you click the lens flare bar itself, you get this teeny little cursor crosshair thing. I know you can't see it. I'm going to try to move my cursor around it. So I'm going to grab this thing and drag it off to the left. And then I'm going to go to the end of my keyframe. So if you just hit this little button on the flare brightness to go to the next keyframe, it takes me over to the next spot, and I'm going to grab that endpoint. Wrong one. I think I may have changed them around. Sometimes these things are a little finicky on where you're grabbing things. So I've kind of got it in the reverse order here. Let me just grab this guy, move it up here. Grab this one and move it down here. Here's my end. There. I was grabbing the these little Bezier endpoints or whatever they're called. Kind of hard to grab these things. It's a little bit finicky here, but if you fight with it long enough, you'll eventually get it to where you want. So if you watch the cursor here, it's going to start off to the... oops, I did it again. How about we just delete this and start it over again? Sometimes it's easier to do it that way. So here's my beginning lens flare. And I can move it up here, and you can see where the end is. And as I move it, it's really not behaving like I want it to. All right, now I've got this thing a little more under control. It's extremely difficult to see. I will try to explain what's happening. If you look by this gentleman over here in the far left, there's that small crosshair looking thing, and there's this little Bezier curve adjustment thing, and you can see the dotted line sort of moving across the screen there. That's actually the path that the lens flare is going to go in. In the very far right hand side, that's where the lens flare goes to. So what will happen here is it starts to the left and it goes to the right with this big giant flash in the middle there. So we play this thing, let me play it from about the beginning here so you can see these two effects. It's a little bit of lens flare. Now it's not real fast, it's not real controlled and whatnot, it's not really pretty, but the point is that's how you create an effect across two different clips. Last thing I'll show you is just a dead simple one here, and that's the vignetting one. So I'm going to again grab my vignette from my effects. I'm going to drag it on top of the entire adjustment layer, and as you would expect, it's going to add a vignette to the entire clip, which I don't want. I want that to kind of vignette in and vignette out, if that's the proper terminology here. So again, you guessed it, so if your keyframe is off and your window's collapsed, just make sure you have that large enough so you can see it. Turn your keyframes on, and at the very beginning of your video, if you want to change your amount, just click the toggle animation. I'm going to set it to, say, zero, just to have everything off. And then somewhere along the way, I have no idea where, and I really don't care at this point, I'm going to crank the vignetting way up just to make it drastically different so you can see it, and then maybe back to a zero or something like that. I have no idea what it's going to look like. Probably pretty ugly, but it doesn't matter. This is just an example of how to create effects across different clips. So we'll play this. You see the vignetting coming in, the flickering, the lens flare, and then the vignetting is very strong, and now it seems to go back. Now, you're probably going to want to change the timing here so things go a little bit faster, a little bit slower and whatnot, but that's the idea of how you can apply things across clips. Now, let me get rid of this adjustment layer. Let me bring my other one in. I've just done a few more things to this thing. Nothing fancy here, but it gives you the idea of I have a lot more effects on this thing. So let me go ahead and play it. Now, you might not like those effects, and to be honest with you, I'm not sure I really like them either. Some are too close together, some aren't really accentuated very well, but the point is, here's how you create effects across multiple clips without having to save your entire movie out and then bring it back in. All right, folks, that's all I had for you on this video here. I hope you learned something. If you did, give me a thumbs up. If not, please leave a comment, and I'll try to do a better job next time. Thanks for watching.